Are you all familiar with hearth cooking?
The way we have it set up here, the fellows did a wonderful job. They did it historically correct. We have a bar up here, which the chickens are hanging on. It's an iron bar. Early on, most people didn't have access to iron. And so they put wooden poles in there. They called lug poles. And the women hung their heavy pots on them. This is before these things were put in. And the fire dried out the poles, the heavy pots, the weight. Those poles cracked, came tumbling down into the crash, and women were scalded. They weren't scalded to death, but they had nothing to fight infection. This was the second leading cause of death amongst women during this time in history. So out of necessity, these cranes, this is called a crane.
Sarah.
You can see how easily,
Sarah.
How easily you can take off, put on, and this was very safe. And when this happened, the women said, we can never have anything any better in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. We have it all now.
So you could push that clear back in right over the fire if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm. But I don't want my pork and sauerkraut to cook dry because I'd like to
might
end
need
up
it for a little bit
have to go back to your pot. Okay.
Because that cast iron will hold the heat anyway.
Oh, yeah. This is the way everybody had to cook if they wanted to eat just prior to the Civil War. At that time in our country, we were casting iron, and then the heavy cook stoves replaced this way of cooking. But we feel in this area, they probably hearth cooked a couple years more than most people because of the war. This area was so financially and in every way devastated from the war, that people were rebuilding their homes, rebuilding their farms and whatever. And so to spend money for a newfangled stove would not have been something they'd have given priority to. So they probably cooked this way several years longer.
Penny.
Keep that fire going all day too.
Most of the time, especially in the winter time, the fires never went out. They would just kind of bank them down a little bit, and they would keep the fire going all the time.